Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be showing you the recipe for these beautiful, festive looking, delicious chicken puffs. You can serve these up at any event and they are guaranteed to be a crowd pleaser. Before I get into this video, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you have not, and if it's your first time here, I welcome you. Let's get right into it. To start off my choux paste, I am using eggs, salt, sugar, butter. I am not using the actual 100% butter, I'm using margarine, olive oil margarine, just to save cost. I have flour and I am using water. So let's head over to the pot. In my pot, I am adding the water, salt, sugar, and for the fat, I am adding the butter. This is for flavor and to prevent the flour from clumping. I am just allowing everything to come to a simmer, not a boil. And I would add the flour. Now that it's simmering, it's not onto a boil. There's light smoke that is coming from inside the pot, and that's what you're looking for. And I'm gonna add the flour now. And I am going back in with my spatula. You want to mix this until you see a light film and all the flour is coated in the liquid. And what you are looking for is a mixture to come into a ball, leaving a light film at the bottom of the pot. And you also want to cook this on a low heat, low and slow, to make sure that the flour cooks properly. The film has started to come, but I still want to make sure that my flour cooks out. Still seeing bits of flour. And I want to get all of that out by pressing as I see the white of the flour. From this point, it should take about 5 minutes to cook. The film has started to come, if you would see here. And I'm not sure if I mentioned before, you must cook this in very low heat because it will burn. Heat levels from 1 to 8, and I am cooking this on a level 3. When this is done, I am going to put this in a bowl and allow it to cool down completely. I'm just going to put it in my bowl and set it aside. While the choux paste is cooling, I am going to start my chicken filling. I am using 2 leg and thighs for this. You can also use chicken breast. I am going to debone these and you will see how I will prepare it. So I've since deboned and washed these out, and I am going to start the preparation for the chicken filling. I am seasoning this with a light seasoning. So I've added homemade green seasoning. I'm going to add a little bit of pepper. And a little bit of sea salt. And I'm just gonna give this a really quick mix. I don't need to over season this at this point because there's a lot of flavors that are gonna go into this. I have a pot of simmering water and I am going in with 3 cloves of garlic, 1 small piece of chicken bouillon. I am adding the chicken to this and allow it to cook. I'm just gonna give this a nice mix and allow the chicken to cook. The temperature of the choux paste has dropped and it's time to add the eggs without it being scrambled. I am adding the eggs one at a time. I am making this entire recipe by hand, which is very difficult. It takes a lot of time to mix the eggs into the choux paste, but we are gonna do this. If you have not yet subscribed to the channel, please, please, please click the subscription button, click the notification bell and the thumbs up button. Drop a comment in the comment section and let me know where you are watching from. I am from Trinidad and Tobago, and I would like to know you. Now I am adding the second egg. And I just want to use pressing motion. Long time when you used to make choux paste, you had to use your hand. For the third egg, and now for the last and final egg, we are almost there. And this is just about done. And I would suggest if you have a mixer to save time, you can use it. Now for the next step. To pipe these, I am using a 6B tip. You don't have to use this, you can use a different kind of tip. I am using a silicone piping bag. If you are using a disposable bag, I would suggest you double it up. And if you are using a Ziploc bag, I will also suggest you double it up. I am making some big chicken puffs, about 3 inches. So you want to go in with your tip. You want to cover that 3 inches. This should be like this. And you want to overlap and come over. And I'm going to show you how to remove those tips and get them nice and flat without burning. And we are almost done. To remove the tip, I am just dipping my finger in water and just pat them down. For the egg wash, I am using 1 egg and 1 tablespoon of water. And guys, I am adding 2 more tablespoons of water to the egg wash. So that is a total of 3 tablespoons. And this is because normally I spray water on my choux pastry before I bake them. But I don't have one on hand right now, so I added the water to the egg wash. This way I will get more steam from the egg wash. Now I'm going to brush my pastry. Just a gentle brush. Now it's time to bake these up, and I'm going to have all the ingredients and the baking time in the description box below. The chicken thighs are done. And I will now transfer these to my food processor and grind them up. The chicken is now done, and I have ground this up in my food processor, and now it's time to finish it off. For the flavors, I am adding some parsley and green onions. You don't have to chop these the way how I chop them, you can grate them as well. Some chopped green peppers, chopped red peppers, and onions. I am adding a dash of Cajun seasoning to this because I want a little bit of heat to it. Just a dash of chili flakes. Some cracked black pepper. I am adding 1/2 cup of mayo, and I am mixing. I want this to look very pretty and very colorful. It smells amazing, guys. You should try this recipe. And if you try this recipe, please drop it in the comment section below and let me know how it turned out. Now I'm going to taste it for salt. I'm adding 1 teaspoon of salt to this. And then I'm adding just a teaspoon of lime juice, fresh lime juice. So this is a savory pastry, and I want the word savory to have its meaning. And this is done. These are almost done, and I'm just gonna poke them 3 holes on each one and put them back in my oven at a higher temperature. This is because I want the moisture from inside of them to dry out. The patio shoes are now done, and I have since allowed them to cool. They are very soft and stand up. To fill these, I could just pipe it in the bottom of the piping bag, or I could just slice them, which I am going to do that way. I am just gonna cut these halfway so you can see the inside. And now I'm gonna fill these up. And here you have it, some crowd-pleasing chicken puffs, Caribbean style. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to the channel. Give this video a huge thumbs up, drop a comment in the comment section. Please be sure to click the notification bell, that whenever I do a new video, you will be notified.